the history of e-commerce, from its origins to modern day. Electronic commerce, or e-commerce, refers to buying and selling products and services on the internet. E-commerce can happen in many forms, like ordering goods, purchasing a service, buying a subscription to an information source, or even setting up an online bill-paying schedule. For most of us, it's hard to imagine modern life without e-commerce. It would not only be inconvenient, but also much more complicated. Still, as ingrained as e-commerce has become in our lives, it wasn't that long ago when it didn't even exist. So when was online shopping invented? Companies have been using computer networks to conduct business since as far back as the 1960s, but that version of e-commerce would be almost unrecognizable to us nowadays. It wasn't until 1979 that the American National Standards Institute finally stepped in and introduced a standard for sharing business documents. It was called Accredited Standards Committee X12 and gave companies a reliable standard for sharing documents over electronic networks. 1979 also witnessed another first for the internet age, the origin of e-commerce. In 1979, English inventor Michael Aldridge introduced and pioneered what would eventually become known as e-commerce by connecting television and telephone lines. The story goes that Aldridge thought of the idea while on a walk with his wife, bemoaning the inconvenience of making regular trips to the market. Wouldn't it be so much easier if you could just order what you needed through the TV? Shortly thereafter, he invented a system that advertised goods and services on television, giving viewers the ability to call into a processing center to place orders. Aldridge called his system teleshopping. And so, e-commerce was born. Throughout the 80s and into the early 90s, the internet continued to evolve as new technologies like SSL made it something more and more people were comfortable using. In 1982, French innovators launched the Minitel, a service that was a precursor to the World Wide Web. This service was free for telephone subscribers and used a video text terminal and telephone line to connect millions of people. The Minitel expanded, and by 1999, more than 9 million terminals connected about 25 million people. However, the World Wide Web soon caught up. Debuting to the public in 1991, its rapid rise quickly eclipsed the Minitel. In 2012, France Telecom officially discontinued the Minitel service. So what about the first e-commerce stores? Technically, the first e-commerce company was Boston Computer Exchange, which launched all the way back in 1982. It was primarily an online market that served people who wanted to sell their used computers. With the arrival of the internet, another, more familiar kind of store debuted. Bookstacks Unlimited, which opened its virtual doors in 1992, was an online bookstore that actually predated a company which would quickly become synonymous with the term by two whole years, Amazon. Eventually, Bookstacks Unlimited was acquired by Barnes & Noble. The World Wide Web becomes user-friendly. In 1990, Tim Berners-Lee and Robert Caillou published a proposal to build a hypertext browser called World Wide Web. During that same year, Berners-Lee also designed the first web server. On August 6, 1991, Berners-Lee made history yet again when he debuted the first website, ushering in the World Wide Web as a publicly available service. The National Science Foundation relaxed restrictions governing the commercial use of the internet a short time later, which paved the way for online shopping. In 1995, the National Science Foundation started charging user fees for registration of domain names. In just 3 years, registered domain names jumped from 120,000 to more than 2 million. Many concerns around the security of online shopping persisted, but the development of secure socket layers, SSL, technology made it possible to send data over the internet safely. Browsers identified authenticated SSL certificates on websites, indicating whether websites were safe and trustworthy. The SSL encryption protocol continues to be a prominent feature of web security. Marketplaces, payment, and mobile e-commerce. After the formative years of the internet, advancements began to take hold that increased its commercial use. As we've covered, Amazon launched in 1995, initially as an online bookstore. During that time, large brick and mortar bookstores could only be expected to carry about 200,000 books at most. However, as an online store, Amazon had no such limitations. It could carry countless titles from bestsellers to obscure texts. Since its founding, Amazon has expanded to the point that it now offers virtually every type of product imaginable, including ebooks and movies. Amazon also pioneered the sharing of user reviews, an idea that was originally considered e-commerce suicide. Of course, the exact opposite happened. By letting customers share their feedback, Amazon became one of the most powerful companies in the world, seemingly overnight. Meanwhile, eBay emerged as a successful online auction website, debuting in 1995. In 2005, Etsy launched as a global marketplace where people could create shops to sell their unique and often handmade items. During that same year, Amazon launched Amazon Prime, a service that offered members free two-day shipping within the continental United States. This program set a standard in e-commerce, forcing other merchants to decrease shipping time and charges. PayPal launched in 1998 as a global e-commerce company that offered payment processing for online vendors and other commercial users. PayPal customers can hold, send, and receive funds in many different currencies. In 2004, the Payment Card Industry Security Standards Council was created to make sure that businesses comply with security requirements. This organization develops and implements security standards for account data protection. As mobile computing began to develop and grow, Amazon launched its first mobile website in 2011, starting the mobile e-commerce race. Because more people were using their mobile services to access e-commerce websites, the push to make mobile sales possible was strong. Consumers today use mobile devices not only for purchases, but also for product research, to find coupons, and to engage via social media. So what does the future look like for e-commerce? E-commerce and consumer trends will continue to evolve as technology expands and changes. The Census Bureau estimated that US retail e-commerce sales for the fourth quarter of 2019 were at $158 billion, an increase of 2.6% from the third quarter. Expect that trend to continue for many years to come. One example of technology dramatically shaping the future of e-commerce is advancements in different screen types. Soon, consumers will interact with e-commerce touchpoints via wearables, kiosks, and improved voice interactions. E-commerce personalization will continue to push the field too. We're already at the point where sites can remember customers and tailor their e-commerce experiences accordingly. This doesn't just improve conversions and customer satisfactions. It also produces game-changing data that companies can use to craft even better experiences for their website's visitors. So how do you compete and thrive in the modern marketplace? As successful as Amazon is, there's no reason your company can't compare and even thrive alongside the retail giant. Much smaller, independent merchants can often connect with consumers in ways that a behemoth like Amazon can't match. These companies can also work to create a memorable brand experience, which helps gain customer loyalty. While the Amazon effect is often seen as a negative for retailers, many have adapted by adopting which practices they can and offering the aforementioned brand experiences Amazon can't. If there's one takeaway from the origins and history of e-commerce, it should be that the industry is constantly changing. New innovations are always just around the corner, which means your company must constantly adapt to stay ahead. Fortunately, countless online businesses have proven this can be done. You just need to follow two simple rules. First, always put your customer first. The very origins of e-commerce are rooted in a desire to give customers more of what they wanted: convenience, selection, and savings. No matter what Google does to its algorithm or which devices become the next user favorite, if you put your customers first, you'll be set up for success. Second, stay flexible. If you let success lead to complacency, you won't be successful for long. Always look for new ways to keep your customers happy, and you'll be sure to repay your efforts. The future of e-commerce looks to be just as exciting as its past. If you keep these two rules in mind, you'll have plenty to be excited about too. Thanks for checking in with us today. If you enjoyed this video, then please give us a thumbs up, comment below, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Until next time.